The Strange Order of Things is the title of my new book, and the book is really about the following idea. When we think about cultures, and when people ask the question, how is it that we have cultures? What made cultures be? How did they come about? The typical answer to this question is to refer to our great intelligence, to our ability to use language, to our social abilities, and so forth. And of course, in order to invent cultures, in order to invent arts and sciences, moral systems, governance, technology, you name it, it's obvious that we need to be intelligent, and it's obvious that we need to be creative. But something that is missing in that very straightforward response is the idea of affect, the idea of feelings, the idea of the emotions and feelings that drive you to do things. And so my take is that, in fact, what has motivated cultural invention and cultural developments is affect, is the presence of feeling, specifically feelings of pain or suffering, or feelings of pleasure, or sometimes even just the possibility of pleasure. Those were the driving forces to create new instruments and new practices that we describe as cultural. It also happens that feelings and affect in general are the key monitors of the process of culture. So once there is an invention that is cultural, that invention is going to stick or not, is going to remain or not, depending on whether or not it works. And whether or not it works depends on how we feel about it. Is it something that is really producing positive feelings, or something that produces negative feelings? And that is a component. In other words, the negotiation that we do in order to maintain or discard a cultural invention is not made exclusively on the basis of knowledge and intellect. It's not on the basis of reasoning alone. In other words, it's not about reason only. It's also about affect. It's also about emotion and feeling. This is a very important idea. Now, you may ask, why is it strange? Why do I have this strange order? What does it refer to? Well, it refers to the fact that when you look at the origins of feeling, which I find so important, well, I would say that in order to have feelings, we need to have living organisms with nervous systems, and that's a relatively recent development in the history of evolution. But then you realize that long before there were nervous systems, and long before there were feelings as such, lots of living creatures, in fact very simple creatures, already had something that could be called pre-cultural, or could be called a foreshadowing of what culture became. And it turns out that those creatures do not have nervous systems. Those creatures have a body, have life, have homeostatic regulation, but they do not have nervous systems. So the title, The Strange Order of Things, refers to this very peculiar situation. We have creatures without nervous systems, in which we would not expect to have enormous abilities in terms of their social life, already behaving socially with strategies of cooperation or conflict, for example, strategies of grouping or separation that would seem to be the result of a mind, would seem to come from a creature with a nervous system, with an intelligence, and with consciousness that were highly developed. When in fact what you do have is no mind, no consciousness, no nervous system, although you have intelligence. That's the very critical point. So that's the reason why I talk about the strange order of things, and that is something that I discuss in this new book, whose subtitle is Life, feeling and the making of cultures.